नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रखो बिटिया। दिस इज जेवियन, डॉक्टर राकेश शर्मा, प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑर्गेनम ऑफ मेडिसिन फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ मेंस यूनिवर्सिटी। आवर टुडे सेशन इज रॉबर्ट्स फिलोसॉफी चैप्टर 20, टॉपिक इज टेम्परामेंट पार्ट फर्स्ट। In homeopathic, there is frequent mention of temperaments, especially do we consider temperaments in case taking and in prescribing. Perhaps it is wise to give some consideration to a definition of temperaments and just what weight which should help in taking the case and prescribing. There are four classical temperaments: nervous, bilious, sanguineous, phlegmatic. There are many combinations of these types, usually with one basic type predominating. Sometimes we find people who are very difficult to classify under any type, being a combination of several basic types. These temperaments are to a very large extent physiological, but besides the stature of the patient, the matter of temperaments implies coloring, functional tendencies of circulation, elimination, respiration, and so on, and at the same time mental and emotional tendencies in reaction to environment and circumstances. The matter of temperaments is closely allied with the basic dyskrasias. Basic dyskrasia matlab hota hai abnormal condition, which we have discussed greater length. Our concern at this time is particularly in relation to the temperament as it has been considered an element in prescribing the homeopathic remedy. Means ki temperament se hume prescribe karne ke andar kafi had tak help mil jati hai, lekin ye surety nahi hai ki medicine hamari confirm hogi. इसके लिए हमें मेडिसिन की कैरेक्टरिस्टिक चीजें भी हमें चेक करनी पड़ेगी। इट हैज बीन सेड दैट द टेंपरामेंट आर कास्ट इन द वेरी बिगनिंग ऑफ द न्यू इंडिविजुअल व्हेन द पेशेंट व्हेन द पेरेंट्स सेल्स फर्स्ट यूनाइट एंड दैट वंस कास्ट देयर इज नो डेविएशन फ्रॉम देम एंड दैट व्हाट इज फिजियोलॉजिकल कैन नॉट बी इन्फ्लुएंस्ड और चेंज्ड बाय द एक्शन ऑफ आवर रेमेडीज। Both these statements are to a considerable degree true, but perhaps it would be more definitely true if we said that the initial tendency cannot be changed, but that the homeopathically indicated remedy prescribed accurately to children can so modify the physiological tendencies as to prevent their unfavorable ultimates to a considerable degree. There is lot of confusion between constitution and the temperament. Constitution is the basic nature of the person. Temperaments becomes to change according to circumstances of the person. The morbific influences that are attractive to temperamental tendencies are amenable to treatment and can be removed by the homeopathic remedy. This in itself is greatly preventive of the dangers arising from temperamental weakness. The homeopathic prescription is often biased by the temperament to the extent that certain temperaments bring out certain symptom picture and much more readily than the other so-called temperaments. For instance, the phlegmatic type is essentially sluggish, dull in reaction. We expect to find venous stasis a marked tendency of this temperament. The opposite of the sanguineous, the nervous temperament, as it implies, would indicate quick action, the high strung type. In the bilious, we expect to find a tendency to liver disorders. Just so far as the temperaments are classified, develop symptom in their conventional lines may be depend upon them as guides in the selection of the remedy. तो सिर्फ ये temperament हमें medicine के selection के अंदर guide कर सकते हैं। हर temperament का एक अपना individual dyskrasia होता है, abnormal conditions होती है, एक disposition होती है। if we look into the case further, in the light of the hereditary dysgrasias that tend toward certain developmental changes, we will see more clearly the indications for our remedies than if we merely look at surface groupings. We often hear patients classified on snap judgment as a pulsatile patient, Lakshmanika patient, or perhaps a phosphorus patient because of the general build and coloring associated with these remedies. Many mistakes have been made in prescribing on this so-called type method. Let us analyze the reasons we have for considering a phlegmatic blonde woman as a pulsatile patient. Do we mean that this coloring always indicates pulsatile? Do we mean that a woman of this type never requires Lakshmanika? If we do, we have based our conclusions on a half. What we really mean is that the stout young woman with blue eyes, fair hair, and pale skin has developed more and more clearly cut symptoms under the probing than people of other coloring or stature. On the other hand, the best prover of Lakshmanika were fiery dark men. This means that the natural physical makeup of certain people predisposing them to certain reactions under certain circumstances makes them particularly susceptible to certain disease influences, whether these disease influences are natural or artificial. In other words, the temperament has caused in the beginning of their existence predisposes to certain morbid reactions, and if not controlled, they will develop these reactions under certain circumstances. So temperament को लेके हम clear cut indication medicine के बारे में नहीं लगा सकते हैं. जैसे कि Lakshmanika को हम कहते हैं कि male remedy है, उसका मतलब ये नहीं कि हम females में नहीं दे सकते, और pulsatile को ये नहीं है कि हम males में नहीं दे सकते. बात यह है कि इसके कैरेक्टरिस्टिक सिम्टम्स हमें इसमें दिखने चाहिए. दिस सेशन पावर्ड बाय डिजिटल वर्जन 2.0 ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी. आई होप यू आर सेटिस्फाइड विद माय डिजिटल सेशन. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी प्लीज मेंशन इन कमेंट बॉक्स, आई विल रिजॉल्व इट. सो वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस चैप्टर इन आवर नेक्स्ट physical class. Thank you.